Mozart's Magic Flute, Handel's Xerxes, Puccini's Turandot, Nietzsche's Thus Spoke Zarathustra, Goethe's Das Ostliche Divan, Hegel's Philosophy of History, Edward Fitzgerald's Rubaiyat Omar Khayyam, Matthew Arnold's Tragedy of Sohrab and Rustam, Montesquieu's Persian Letters, Gauguin and Cezanne's paintings. There is an endless list of the masters and masterpieces of European art, literature, music, poetry, and philosophy, in which we note an irresistible attraction to things Persian, an attraction that marks the multifarious persophilia. Whence the origin and wherefore the destination of the European and thence global fascination with things Persian? In Persophilia, Persian Culture on the Global Scene, I explore the landscape of a spectacular circulation of ideas between East and West that effectively dismantles those two coded illusions and posits a global scene upon which Persian culture was staged. From the biblical stories of Esther and Mordecai to Xenophon's Cyropedia, from the philosophies of Hegel and Nietzsche to the music of Handel and Mozart, from the poetry of Matthew Arnold's Sohrab and Rustam and Fitzgerald's Rubaiyat of Omar Khayyam to the classical texts ranging from Montesquieu's Persian Letters to Goethe's Das Ostliche Divan. From the rise of the European Enlightenment and Romanticism to the height of American Transcendentalism, down to the groundbreaking arts of Gauguin and Matisse. I map out a spectacular geography of European social, intellectual, and artistic history in which Persia and Persian culture were definitive, and which in turn went back to Iran and its Persianate continental context to cause groundbreaking historical changes. The result is an epistemically provocative reading of world cultural and political history, seismic in its proportions and nerving in its dismantling of normative historiography, and transformative in its theoretical implications for radically altering our reading of the postcolonial nation-states. In my Persophilia, I seek critically to alter our conception of the European and therefore global fascination with Persian, and by extension Oriental, culture by locating it on the transnational bourgeois public sphere and thus show it to be definitive to the social, intellectual, and artistic movements of the 18th and the 19th century, from the Enlightenment and Romanticism to the American and French revolutions. But all of that is only half of the story of Persophilia. For my concern with the European fascination with the Persian culture does not remain stationary and static on the European site and travels eastward to Iran and its continental environment to see in what particular ways the echoes and reflections of this persophilia turn out to play transformative roles in the course of nation states, the production of a transnational public sphere, and the formation of the postcolonial subject. Determined radically to recast our understanding of European and non-European social and cultural history, my persophilia is performed in a dramatic key in comparative cultural criticism, effectively decentering Europe by bringing it into the fold of the larger regional and global history. With a steely and unwavering gaze, persophilia harbors neither an animosity towards the West, nor an ahistorical celebration of ideas and social formations in the East. Dismantling that false binary, I follow the circularity of capital, labor, and marketplace of ideas and social movements the occasion, and thus seek to reveal a vision of global history that will break new epistemic grounds for the next generation of scholarship to come.